Hi everyone. This question is from the 1987 Australian Mathematics Competition, and only 5% of the junior students got it right. It was also a question in the intermediate and senior competitions, and 8% and 15% of those students got it right. So it was relatively hard throughout all of high school. Okay, so the question goes like this. We've got these two candles. The taller one will burn for 7 hours, while the shorter one will burn for 10 hours. And after 4 hours of burning, both candles are the same height. We need to work out the shorter candle's height divided by the longer candle's height. So pause the video here and see if you can figure that one out. Okay, so first of all, what's really useful for a wide variety of questions is trying to represent the information you have in a diagram. So I've already got these pictures of the candles. But how about to represent the fact that this one lasts for 7 hours, what we could do is just sort of cut it into 7 pieces, representing like where each piece represents 1 hour of burning. So like after 1 hour, that'll be gone and it'll just be that high. So after 4 hours, let's take off 4 of those pieces. And then for the 10, this one's a little bit harder to draw. Because all the pieces are so small. But it's gonna be something like that. And again, we can just take off 4 of these to represent what happens after 4 hours. All right, now, what I wanna show you with this question is how easy it is to turn a guess and check sort of way of thinking into an equation, because a lot of people have trouble writing algebraic equations just out of a word problem, while they can still do a guess and check just fine. So I'll show you how to turn a guess and check into an algebraic equation. So let's just have a guess at the heights of these candles. For this one, we really want it to be a multiple of 7 so that we can cut it into these 7 pieces. So let's say that this is 21 centimeters high. So that height is 21. And for this one, we want it to be able to be cut into 10 pieces. So let's say it's 20 centimeters high. And then let's try to work out what the heights would be after 4 hours. So what we could do is we could say, we could work out the height of each little piece. So if there's 7 pieces and they make 21 centimeters altogether, then to work out the height of one piece, we could do 21 divided by 7. So that would be 3. Each one is 3 centimeters high. And then you can see that after 4 hours, there's 3 of them left. So we've got 3 times whatever that height was. So that would make 3 times 3, which is 9. It would end up being 9 centimeters high at the end. Another way that you could do it is you could sort of just look at this and say, okay, what's remaining is 3/7 of the total. So we could say that it's 3/7 of 21. And that also gives you 9 if you work that out. So let's do the same with this one. So we could say, we could go 20 divided by 10 to give the height of each piece and then times, so there'd be 6 left if there's 10 altogether and we've taken 4 off. So you could do it like that, or you could think of it as being this as being 6/10 of the total. So we've got 6/10 of 20. So that one made 9. This one is going to make 12. So we can see that that guess doesn't work. Now, what we would really like to do is call the height of this maybe x, and the height of this one y, and like turn it into an equation that we can solve in some way. So this was our guess here, the 21, and this was our guess for this one. So what you want to do is just take your guesses and replace them with x and y. So 3/7 of x instead of 3/7 of 21. And for this one, the height it's going to end up as is 6/10 of y. And then we know that these two things are supposed to be the same number, because that was what they said, that after 4 hours burning, the two candles are the same height. So we could say that we want 3/7 of x to equal 6/10 of y. So that's how easy it is to turn a guess and check into an equation. You just take your guesses and replace them with x and y. Okay, so now let's see what we can do with this. We're trying to work out the short candle's height divided by the long candle's height. So what we want to end up with is y divided by x equals something, or y over x equals something. Same thing. So let's see what we can do with this to turn it into something like this. So what I'm thinking is, if we divide both sides by x, that'll move it over here and we'll have y divided by x. So that's really good because that's what we want. So let's do that. So just divide both sides by x. And then on the left, we've still got 3/7. And then on the right, we've got 6/10 times y divided by x. And then because we just want to have y divided by x by itself, what we want to do is get rid of this 6/10. So move that over the other side. And to do that, because it's multiplied by the rest of this stuff, to shift it across, we divide. So divide by 6/10. And so we end up with y divided by x on the right, and on the left we've got 3/7 divided by 6/10. So we just need to work out what that is. We could simplify this first of all. So 3/5. And you know what, I'm just going to put this over the other side, because then you don't have to rewrite it each time. You can just say equals and leave this blank. Okay, now to divide by a fraction, we multiply by the reciprocal, so times 5/3. Reciprocal just means flip it upside down. And then you can just multiply across, or because we've got these two threes here, you can just cancel them. So, you know, I'll show you both ways. If you just multiply across, you'll have 15/21, so 7 times 3 making 21, and then you have to simplify this. So you'd have to divide each one by 3, so you get 5/7. Or an easier way to do that is just to recognize that there's these two threes here and we can just cancel them. So we just end up with 5/7. So that's the answer to that question. All right, that's it for now. Remember to like and subscribe and stay tuned for the next video.